You're watching The City Newsroom. My name is Bobie Osei. Now, government in recent times has announced that it has dedicated 13 billion Ghana cedis or so to dealing with issues around the financial sector cleanup, key amongst them the payment of depositor claims. Now, the cleanup led to the collapse of 9 banks, 347 microfinance institutions, 23 savings and loans and finance houses, among others. Now, after that, the Bank of Ghana sent all related files relating to these financial institutions to law enforcement bodies, urging them to do the needful. By doing the needful, they meant charge persons or institutions responsible for the collapse of these institutions. So last year, we saw the first case with regards to the financial sector cleanup being brought against Ato Asian, Fitzgerald, among other leadership of Capital Bank. Then we saw a case being brought against the founder of UT Bank as well as Beige Bank, Kofi Amoabeng and Michael Nyinako. They were all brought before this particular court. They've all been granted bail to the tune of hundreds of millions of Ghana cedis. Now, today, the founder of Unibank, Dr. Kwabena Dufour, alongside his son, Kwabena Dufour Jr., the former second deputy governor of the Bank of Ghana, Johnson Esiema, among some senior members of that defunct bank, have all been charged with 68 counts of fraudulent breach of trust, money laundering, among others. Now, Dr. Kwabena Dufour, we know, is in court to respond to these charges. On today's edition of the City Newsroom, we will be following this case and bringing you the relevant angles that develop from today. My name is Bobie Osei. Now, after 6 hours of court proceedings, we are seeing some lawyers coming out of the Accra High Court. Particular, we are seeing the defense lawyers coming out of the building. In your short, here's the Attorney General herself, Madam Gloria Kufo. Now, she has been prosecuting the case for the state against the accused persons, including the founder of Unibank, Dr. Kwabena Dufour, as well as the case involving the founder of UT Bank, Prince Kofi Amoabeng. Now, it is important to note that the presiding judge, with regards to these cases, has warned all the lawyers involved not to grant any interviews, or he will himself report them to the General Legal Counsel. Now, some other individuals we've seen today are family members of some of the accused persons who trooped to the Accra High Court to offer some type of support. Also, we've seen some accused persons, even though, I mean, we have primed our cameras and looking at capturing the prime individuals involved in the case, that is Dr. Kwabena Dufour, his son Kwabena Dufour Jr., Prince Kofi Amoabeng. It appears that they found a way of exiting the facility without the media men who are stationed right at the entrance and noticing. So the court has granted bail to the founder of Unibank, Dr. Kwabena Dufour, as well as Prince Kofi Amoabeng, the founder of UT Bank. Now, for details, I have my court correspondent here with me, Fred Tetijabana, to shed more light on exactly what transpired today in court.
Yes, so we'll be, there are two different cases. One case had to do with the issue of Unibank, the defunct Unibank, and some of its directors and owners who are brought to court. And the second case had to do with UT Bank and some of its directors and some people, former officials of the Bank of Ghana. So let's start with the Unibank case. That case has to do with an amount of over 5 billion Ghana cedis. 5.7 billion Ghana cedis, where we are told where it was mismanaged by some officials of the defunct Unibank, including the founder of the bank, Kwabena Dufour, the CEO at the time the bank collapsed, Kwabena Dufour Jr. Then we have the former BOG deputy governor, Johnson Esiema, and some other officials of Unibank. We are told that they are facing charges including fraud and money laundering. And today, essentially, what happened was that their charges were read to them, and all of them have pleaded not guilty to the charges which have been leveled against them. The charges are about 8, and they have pleaded not guilty to all the 8 charges and 68 counts of different charges brought against them. The next thing was for the application for bail by their lawyers. Their lawyers have applied for bail. The bail was not objected to by the Attorney General. According to Attorney General, she's not opposed to the bill, but she believes that the bill should be commensurate with the charge and the amount of money involved in the case. Initially, the judge granted a bill of 100 million cedis. This 100 million cedis had three sureties, two to be justified. They were also expected to deposit their passport with the registry of the court. And there was some issue with this particular 100 million cedi initial bill. According to the lawyers of the accused persons, they thought this 100 million cedis was too much and the justification was going to be a problem. So they pleaded with the court for the court to review its own decision in granting the bill. The court listened to the lawyers. They're led by Dominic Ayene, who is a deputy attorney general. He's representing Dr. Kobna Dufour Sr. The judge, after listening to their plea, decided to reduce the bail condition from 100 million to 60 million, but he kept the rest of them. That is, to be justified, you needed to bring your passport to the registry. So that was the case for the Unibank. And with the case for the Unibank, the Deputy Attorney General, who was representing one of the accused persons, the former Deputy Attorney General, Dominic Ayene, made some interesting submissions in court. According to him, the charges which have been brought against his client and the other accused persons were charges which were unjustifiable. According to them, these charges could not stand. And he actually asked the court to dismiss the charges if it could. But this didn't really carry on, because this is just the initial stage of the trial. The second issue had to do with UT Bank, where we had Johnson Esiama again, who is the first accused person. We have Raymond Amamfo, a former director of banking supervision at the Bank of Ghana. We have the founder of the UT Bank, Prince Kofi Amoabin, and some other four persons who are also involved in this new case. These people are accused to have mismanaged different sums of money, which we are said led to the bank collapsing some few years ago. In their case, they also applied for bail, and the court decided to grant them bail. But you must recollect that Johnson Esiama is facing trial in two different cases. Because of that, he was granted 60 million bail in the first one. The judge says that because of that, he was granting him a self-recognizance bail, meaning that he didn't need to bring another 60 million to be justified. The rest of the people, including Amoabin, Prince Kofi Amoabin, also have been placed with a 60 million bail condition. They also have to deposit their passports with the court's registry. And this 60 million, it needs to be justified by two people. There's another lady in this particular case who is the fifth accused person. She was granted a bail to the sum of 20 million, two sureties to be justified. The case has been adjourned to the 26th of March, where the case will be recalled and would continue the process from there.
Just by way of education, looking at the figures involved with the Capital Bank, for example, Atoisi and the likes, they were granted bail to the tune of about 670 million. Now, you mentioned the issue of whether or not the bail sums were commensurate with the crimes or the monies involved. With Unibank and then the leadership, it was about 5.7 billion. So the 60 million you are speaking of, is it for each and every one, or it covers all of them?
Yes, so the 60 million is for each accused person. So it's not a sum put together, it's not a total sum. So each accused person would have to pay, or would have to bring a bill, an amount of 60 million in terms of properties or any other thing to be justified. So the 60 million is not just for the...
Yes. That brings the figure close to about 540 million thereabout.
Exactly, exactly. Wow.
So where then do we move to from here?
The normal court procedure will take place. As we speak now, as I said, the case has been adjourned. We are expecting the case to be called for the Unibank one to be called on the 24th of March, and the UT Bank one will be called on the 26th of March. During this, when it's called, the normal processes would go through discoveries or evidence which will be relied on, or will be presented to the court, and the court would decide how the case would move from there.
Thank you so very much. That's our court correspondent, Fred Tete Jabano, basically breaking down what has happened in court today with regards to the bail, bail conditions that have been granted to the founder of Unibank, as well as some 8 other persons, and also the founder of UT Bank, and you know, other persons that have been charged with them. We're going to cross over to my colleague Fromer Dunyami to bring us some more stories.